If I remember correctly, that is. Okay, let's see. I hope I'm right. If not, I'll be wasting your time, and that makes me a bad Let's Player. But then again, it also makes me a blind one. There we are. Okay, so I didn't scan these things. Good thing I did now. So, let's see. Okay, so that's one latch out. Two. Okay, one remains, and it's right here. Now would you let me in? Thank you. Okay. Am I missing anything here? Doesn't seem like it. Alright, down to make more cameras we go. Because I don't have the ice beam, and to go to where we have to go, I need the ice beam. The question also is, where do I get it? Is there a secret passageway that the map isn't showing me? Okay. Let's explore my more caverns real quick, and we'll be back here later. I swear I'm not lost. Okay, so I had to make sure I'm actually recording, because for a moment I thought I wasn't. That would have been horrifying, considering I just saved. Alright, so far so good. I hope I'm doing things right. That's not what I want you to open. See, what haven't I explored here? Pretty much stuff that requires the item, but I know I missed something around here, I believe? Yeah, so we'll go there. Wait, is that the one that takes us to Vendrana Grove? Because I know I left something there by accident. Yeah, that's the one. Okay, so we'll go there. And then we'll head back to the Johto Ruins to try and go to that furnace area. Which I'm pretty sure we can't do anything there at the moment. But if the game is pushing me there, that means I can. Maybe I get the ice beam there and then head out that way? What do you want? I don't know why, this might seem like a weird thing to compliment, but that hall and this entire area, I don't know, it feels very well textured. Actually, can I scan them through here? Okay, I already scanned them apparently. I almost gonna regret getting to the Spitfire area because they're now gonna be all over the place. Oh, they do hurt you! Oh, so it's a so it's not an animation, it's a kamikaze attack. If I'm going down, taking you down with me. That looks like it was supposed to be breakable. Okay, so that area is around here. Awesome, it's getting there. That door is that way. Oh, hello! I didn't see you there! Actually, let's try a new one. Without it hitting us, that would be nice. Isn't there a section we already saw already, so that's why I'm not saying much, and I apologize for that. Maybe that's why I should have saved what I'm doing right now for cleanup. But at the same time, I hate... the cleanup is my least favorite part of any Metroid game, so I'd rather get done with it right now. Or at least try to have as little cleanup as possible. Okay, so the thing I'm doing here, the spring ball, this wasn't possible in the original Metroid Prime. You had to do normal Morpal jumps in order to do what I'm doing. And of course these stone platforms break if you bump them too much. But with the flick of the Wiimote, it becomes much, much easier. Okay, so this takes us to Fendrona Drifts. Do I want to go there now? Let's check the map real quick actually. Is there anything here I haven't explored yet? I know I probably missed like Chozo lore, but I can do that later. Doesn't seem like I missed anything, so let's head back to Chozo Ruins to see what the plot wants us to do. Like, after you get the Wave Queen, I think that's a point where I stopped in my previous playthroughs. So right now I'm going completely blind except for like vague memories of Let's Plays that I've seen from Super Gaming Brothers, which by the way, really great YouTube channel. I know it's good for me to be giving a shout out to a channel that's like 20 times the size of my channel, but they're good guys, they're good guys. Check them out if you get the chance. Wait, is that the way I'm supposed to go? Yeah. Or is... yeah, wait, is this it? But yeah, I'm heading the right way. From when I thought I was heading to the way I did Fendrona Drifts south with Magma Caverns. Which is making me wonder, is Chozo Ruins also divided into a north and south, and is that why we haven't gotten all of the map yet? Because if we look at the Chozo Ruins map, there are bits missing connecting the plot area we're supposed to go to next, and everything we've gone through so far. I'm pretty sure we found a map room already. Yeah, this area is a bit easier to find on the way in than on the way out. I can tank your damage, but you need a new energy tank. Like, I admittedly, I'm being reckless, but honestly, I have this much power, I don't care too much. Inside, it's like King K said in one of his review. Another good guy, check him out. I should probably put a I will try to put that link in the description or like in the cards that they're showing now for YouTube videos. Anyway, he did bring up that in Metroid Prime it is very easy to just walk past enemies unless the game makes you fight them. And this is a pretty good example. I just went throughout that entire section that originally I was fighting through, and I just made this jump again. Without much thought. So admittedly the game in that sense shouldn't be too much problem once you start having a good amount of energy tanks. But then again, that is also common in other Metroid games as well, not just Prime. I see Cordite. This is Cordite, right? Please tell me I'm not wrong. I was wrong. Are you Cordite? Anything here Cordite? Pandesium? Other materials? No? Okay. Okay, so which way do we want to go next? We pretty much are gonna go the long way. That's nice. But actually, I'm gonna take a quick break here. I'm gonna go to the bathroom and we'll be right back. Cut! Okay. Wait, which way am I going? Wait. I wanna try something. Maybe I missed it. Like, why would you have all the symbols? Oh, and it resets? How nice of you. Like, why would you have two of the symbols and not the other two? Sadly, I just left, so it has to be in this room. I wasn't... Okay. Maybe waste a super missile. You deserve death! Yeah, super missile. Okay, so scan that again. Okay, so... That's Chozo lore. Come on, it has to be somewhere around here. Do I shoot the pillars? Is that how? Doesn't seem like it. Maybe we need this box? Nope, that's just health. This is frustrating. What the hell is that? Oh! Well, in that case, I guess the other one must be around here as well. There it is! Perfect. So now that opens. We're gonna use Spider Ball track to get that artifact up there. As long as those enemies are not being annoying, little bitches. Ooh. Okay. Okay, I thought I was gonna fall there. Can I switch for that once you go away? There we go. What the? The hell was that? Was... Okay, now I'm scared. What are these? What do you mean an outrage? It's right here! Chozo ghost, what the fuck? I'm guessing it came here early? Oh, and that's bullshit. Every time they hit you, your entire visor starts getting fucked up. Okay, I need you to die real quick. Ah, you asshole. Wait, can they only be hurt by the regular power beam? Then those do too much damage, or maybe I'm just accidentally dodging everything. Ow. Okay. I'm pretty sure that thing wasn't supposed to appear as early as it did, though. That was... Like, when I first entered that area, like, how it was just there. Was that supposed to happen? That looked more like a glitch from the game. Wait. If these are Chozo ghosts, why are they attacking me? I'm the Chozo hero! Why are they attacking me? Old bird, you need some explaining to do. Is this training for Samus like in the manga? Because if Lord, I can't exactly pinpoint where they're gonna appear. There. Okay, that's one. That's two apparently. Wait, no. Come on, just die. Oh, you're annoying. Oh, da. Oh, you annoying little fuck nugget. Okay, that's two. We went this way. Should we appear somewhere around here? Of course, right next to my health. Yeah, I know there's abnormally low temperatures in the Chozo Ruins. I would go there if these things would let me. Ay, ay, ay. There we go. Well, that was annoying. Okay. Samus, get out of the water. Okay. There we go. This one is the Artifact of Wind, the 4th of 12. Okay, we're making good progress then. We are 1/3 of the way there.